So once you've installed Ark from the Epic Games Store onto your chosen hard drive, you're going to have to head to that file on your computer. So I'm going to open My Files right now. And on the screen right now, you'll be able to see my file path. Now, the only difference between my file path and your file path is going to be the hard drive that it's stored on. So mine is stored on the H drive. Yours might be on the C drive, E drive, whatever. That should be the only difference. Now, once you're at the section that we are on, you can go ahead and start adjusting the game ini files and the game user files. But before we do that, there's something important, is that Ark cannot be running at the time that we're editing these files. Ark must be closed, because if Ark is open when you're editing the files, then there's a chance the files won't save correctly. And then in doing so, it's just going to corrupt the files, and then it's going to make this problem a lot harder than it has to be, because then you potentially have to reinstall Ark to fix the files, just to edit the files. So basically, do not have Ark open when you're editing files. Keep it closed at all times. All right, now let's go ahead and open the game user settings. So this is the first one we're going to be modifying. Now the game user settings, this is like where you do all the basic coding. So this is where you'll modify the wild creature levels. This will allow you to adjust the structure pickup time, as well as other basic settings such as show your player map location, decay timers, and server password. Now, when you are in the game user settings, something important to mind is that when you are editing, the only section that you should edit is right here. So where it's got server settings, everything that I've just highlighted and the message of the day is the only part of the file that you edit. You do not edit the play info or anything like that, because if you edit stuff like that, then it's going to cause more problems. As we mentioned, it'll just cause like potential corruption and break the game, and it's going to make your life a lot worse than it would be. So just only edit the stuff under the server settings and the message of the day. That's the only part you touch. All right, now, as well as something to keep in mind, that when you're looking through these server settings, you might realize there's actually a few settings missing. For example, one of them is the player water and food drain. Now, this being the case, you're going to have to actually manually add them in. But don't worry, to make your life easy, all you simply need to do is go onto the internet and go to the wiki server configuration, and then if you're on computer, just go type in control F, and you want to type in food drain. There it is, player character food drain. Double click, copy, control C, and then open up the game file. And then what we're going to do is we're just going to put it here under server settings to make it a bit easier for ourselves. And then we go equals, and then we're going to put in a value, just whatever we want it to be. So there we go. Now we don't have as much painful food drain as it is on our server. Then once you've just added that in, wherever you want, like I said, under the server settings, you can add any code. But once it's added, save the change, close it, and then you can launch up Ark, and that save will have been done, and you're good to go. Now, let us look at the game ini file, because that one's a little bit different. So we're going to open up the game file. Now, everything in the game ini can be edited, except for this line of code. This cannot be touched. Everything else can be changed. Now, the game ini is where the magic happens, because this is where you would add the stacking codes, the auto unlock engram codes, adding non-native dinos to your server, player and dino levels, and so forth and so forth. If you want more information, head to that wiki website that I showed. It's got all the information on every single code. Now, what I like to do, this is just personally me, but when I'm editing anything in the game ini file and I'm adding anything, I like to put it at the bottom. So right now, the crafting skill bonus, that's at the end of the default part of the file. And then as you can see, I've now added the auto unlock engrams and I've started to add my code. So anything that I add into the game ini, I always put at the bottom, just because that's how it works for me best. You can do this alphabetical order, you can do whatever you want, but I prefer to do it under. Now, once you've done your changes, you've added everything, go ahead, save the change again. So go file, save, close it, and then you can go ahead and launch up your Ark and you'll be good to go. Now, there is something else to keep in mind, is that when you are making these modifications, they will only affect your single player world, or if you're hosting a non-dedicated or a dedicated world off your computer. Aside from that though, it will not carry over to another server, and it will not carry over to official. So it only affects you locally. Furthermore, if you want to know how to do certain configurations like auto unlock engrams and stuff like that, I've got a growing playlist of server configurations that I'm going to be linking in the description, as well as a link to a database of code that's completely free of charge. And it's got like all the codes that I've used right now, and it's growing over time as well. So definitely check those out if you want to make your life a little bit easier. But with that being said, everyone, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.